So I'm going to start off by just moisturizing her face. Okay, next I'm going to be using the Professional by Benefit, just in the center of the face. The face is prepped. Next I'm taking some foundation. I'm just going to apply a thin layer. So I'm just first applying it with a flat concealer brush, just to distribute the product. And then I'm just going to blend that in with a big fluffy brush. I'm just going to apply a bit more in the areas that she needs a bit more coverage. To make sure that the makeup under the eye doesn't crease, make sure you don't apply a foundation, because the more product you apply, the more it's going to crease. So if you just skip the foundation under the eye, so keep it clean, so that you, when you apply concealer, it doesn't cake and then crease. Cream contouring her face. Slightly contour and bronze the face. And then I'm going to use my foundation brush just to buff that in. Make sure that's all blended out properly. Now I'm going to take a light concealer, just two shades lighter than her skin tone. And I'm going to take this under the eyes and on the eyelids. Fluffy duofiber brush and blend that out. If you have a dark space just in between your eye and the bridge of your nose, just apply some concealer there so it doesn't it conceals the dark. And when you get close to the eye, just dab with your fingers so that you're just being gentle, because it is a sensitive area. And I'm going to just take some of that product on the bridge of the nose and a little bit on the forehead. Because she has some darkness around her mouth, I'm just going to take a bit of concealer in the same shade as her skin tone around the mouth. Just a tiny bit, just to conceal the darkness. Okay, I'm just going to set all of that in place with some powder. I'm mainly just going to take that around the under the eyes and on the eyelids, around the nose and on the forehead, around the mouth. Bronze the face. Now I'm just going to use short hair-like strokes just to fill in the brows. And I'm using a wax. Keep the brows as natural as possible. So nothing harsh, just be very... keep a light hand. Just flick through the brow, so it has a bit of definition. And I'm just going to comb that out with a spoolie. And then I'm going to set that brow in place. And then the same to the other eyebrow. Okay, now I'm going to start on the eyes, and I'm just going to start off by applying, even though I applied some powder, I'm just going to run Peach Smoothie by Makeup Geek all over the eyelids. Now I'm going to take Latte and Cocoa Bear, just mix them together, and I'm going to run that through the crease. going to take my gel eyeliner and I'm going to use this as a base on her eyelids. So try and keep it as close to the lash line as possible and as intense as you can. As I said before, do not come into the inner corner. Keep the dark shades away from the inner corner because that will just make it look like you've got a black eye. So keep it away from that inner corner and just lay the product below the crease. I'm going to blend that out again with Latte just to diffuse that a little bit. Gel eyeliner with a black eyeshadow, so I'm using Makeup Geek's Corrupt. A bit of Latte and blend that out. I'm using a bit more tapered brush to make sure that everything is blended in the crease. Okay, and I'm just gonna add a bit more Corrupt just to make sure that the black is as intense as it can be. I'm using the other side of the brush again and pat the shadow on the eyelid. Blend again with Latte. Gonna take a bit more fluffy brush just to make sure that it's all blended together. I'm just going to take some concealer and just carve out the brow below because as you can see it's gone a bit too high. Rapunzel by Makeup Geek. Now I'm just going to use a fluffy brush just to get rid of any fallout. Because we set that with the powder, it's just going to brush off easily. Okay, and then I'm just going to take Mermaid by Makeup Geek and just apply that in the middle. It's just such a stunning shade. Do the same on the other eye. And do a tiny bit of blending. So I'm just applying the shadow in the middle and diffusing until I get the perfect amount of payoff. I'm taking the black again, tap off the excess, look up, and take it as close to the lash line as you can. Take the brush, just look up, just to blend that out. Now I'm going to just quickly line the waterline. I'm just going to do one last blend just to make sure everything is seamless. And I'm just going to add a bit more concealer under the eyes just to brighten it up again. I'm just going to apply that mermaid shade again on the lower lash line then in the centre and blend that out. Just like I did on the top lid. I think maybe I could make the blue a bit more intense, so I'm going back in. And I might just use some setting spray just to make the pigment a bit more make the payoff a bit more pigmented. So. Now I'm just going to warm up the face with a bit of bronzer. And then blend that out with a big fluffy brush. High Beam by Benefit. Already cut up some of these red cherry lashes. Okay, in the case. These red cherry lashes, and I've cut them up just so that they give the flare to the end of the eyes, just to make it look more like cat shape. So these are the number 415. First, curl the eyelashes and apply some mascara. Duo Lash glue to stick the lashes onto her eyes. So wait for the glue to dry a bit so that it gets a bit tacky, and just apply the lashes on the end of the eye. So just place the lash . What I do is I just use the end of the tweezers just to press in the ends of the lash band, just to make sure that they are secure in place. Just press the lash down, and remember not to apply the lashes onto the eyelid, but onto the eyelash itself, so that they don't look like they're fake, basically. So make sure you attach the lift lashes to the root of the eyelashes. Okay, I'm just gonna add some blusher, add some of this orange here. I'm just mixing these two colours. About powder brush, and just blend that all in. Now I'm just going to take some of mascara just to coat the lower lashes. So. I'm using Mink by Revlon. So that's the finished look, guys. Thanks for watching. Give it a thumbs up and give it a like and subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you later. Bye.
Bye.
Then when I do care, I'll just report you on YouTube.
you are accepting.
Also, I'm not signing anything.
Well, you're going to.
Verbal acceptance, you are going is not to. Really going to do anything here.
You're going to get me and make sure that.
Really, because it's really easy to report videos
Why?
On YouTube, you know.
Okay, so you have to act like a model, so you can't talk, or you can't, like.
Bro, do I not look like I know this?
Okay. You have to act innocent. Okay, so.
Next time, tell me when we're recording.
What? We are recording.
Yeah, look, no, you that... didn't let me know that we were, and I was like, what the hell?
What does the red thing mean?
I don't know. It's the end of the world?
That helps.
Yeah, because your little baby hairs.
I don't have baby
hair. Okay, so, don't fall asleep. What? A fluffy Duo Fiver blush. What should I do? Choose a colour.
Two dark colours, let's go for goth.
Goth.
Mm, lovely. That looks really good, by the way.
I've done nothing.
I know, but I like it. I would have never thought about using gel as a base for my eyelids.
Really?
No, never. It's because I don't usually put like dark eyeshadows on.
Oh yeah. She's in... Down on the floor. I'm recording by the way.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Okay. Smell it. Oh. It smells like fish.
Gee, thanks.
That's the one let down. The glue smells like fish, guys. Rotten fish. Who else likes fish? I like fish.
I don't.
I do.